Hi, my name is Anne Grieving Brown, and I have another family tip for you and your families during this pandemic crisis. And so my tip today is about the five love languages. This is a book that I have had since approximately 1995-ish, or maybe even before. I've had it an awfully long time. And of course, the five love languages written by Gary Chapman. And he has now come out with many other books and probably a revision to this book. But one of the things that I love most about this is it talks about the five different love languages that everybody has. One of them is words of affirmation, meaning that you love to hear people say, you did a nice job, or I'm proud of you, or I love you. Another one is spending quality time together. That's just simply spending time watching a movie, taking a walk, whatever it may be. Another one is receiving gifts. So that might be small gifts, big gifts, just a little gift here and there. Another one is acts of service. That means that, for instance, that's my love language. So when my husband helps me fold the laundry or cleans up the kitchen, that is how he best expresses love to me. Another one is physical touch. So that's hugs, holding hands, giving a little scratch on the back, those kinds of things. So one of the things I would encourage you to do is to get on the website, and it is the number 5lovelanguages.com. And you can take different tests. You can take one for you and your spouse or your partner, but you can also encourage your teenagers. I just sent the link for my kids to take the test just a few minutes ago. Now I think I pretty much know their love languages, but it's a great way to kind of just have some discussion around the dinner table tonight about how you best receive love. The other thing that the author talks about, that if your love language, for instance, my love language is acts of service. So when somebody does something for me, I feel very loved. But here's the other thing, that my husband's love language is quality time. He loves it when I sit and watch a movie with him. Or spend time going to check cornfields, whether or not the corn is up. So his love language is quality time, but mine is acts of service. So oftentimes the way I express my love to him is through acts of service. But what I really need to be thinking about is that if his is quality time, what am I doing? The same goes for your kids. You know that, moms and dads. You know whether or not your kid is somebody that loves it when you tussle their hair or give their traps a little squeeze or a side hug or whatever, or you know that your kid really appreciates it when you say, good job. So this is just another way to have some great discussion at the dinner table tonight. I encourage you to jump on. Again, I will have the link in the comments below. Thank you very much and have a great day. Stay safe, stay well, and stay healthy. Thank you.